In June 1985, a unique Christian experience, Visions, took place at the National Exhibition Centre, Birmingham, with a cast of over 500. Over 14,000 people came from all over Great Britain to be part of this experience. Did they feel that Visions could be a good way of sharing the gospel with other people?
Yeah. We need to be encouraged in the gospels, and that's what we're looking for tonight, I believe.
It should be a good outreach, yes.
Yeah. This is the best one.
I'm a Christian, and I hope that it'll bring people to God and bring people to Jesus. Yeah.
Given the message in an art form could get to more people and probably would touch them much more than just hearing a sermon.
You've got to be able to project it out to people by sound and light and by acting. It's the easiest way.
Do you think this is a good way of promoting the gospel to other people?
Yeah, effective.
Before the world existed, God was active. He brought order out of chaos, light out of darkness, and life out of the silence.
Up we go. Let me lift you a bit higher. Now I want you to see this. There, look up. What do you see?
I can't see anything, Granddad. It's dark.
It's not completely dark, is it?
There are lots of little lights in the sky.
That's right, all the stars. Aren't they beautiful?
Mm.
Can you see that one there? I think that one's the brightest, don't you?
No, that one.
Maybe. There's so many to choose from. Do you know how many?
No.
Well, there are more stars than anyone can count. Hundreds, thousands, hundreds of thousands.
Granddad, where'd they all come from?
God made them. He made everything.
How did God make everything?
In the beginning there was God and nothing else. No stars, no mountains, no animals, no people, nothing.
What happened then, Granddad?
Everything was dark. It was all empty and silent. Then God sent the power of the Holy Spirit, like a driving wind, and God created the universe.
The one thing King Solomon will be most remembered for is the building of the temple in Jerusalem. When it was finished, everyone went in to worship God.
I don't know where you get the ideas from.
I don't know, all my ideas. King Solomon himself told me exactly what he wanted.
He doesn't do things by half, does Solomon? Do you know, they tell me he's conscripted 150,000 men to work on this temple.
And that's not including the King of Tyre's craftsmen.
I wonder what it cost.
I've no idea. But I'll tell you this. I've never worked with finer materials.
You can say that again. That beautiful cedar wood from Lebanon. And all that gold from Parvay.
You should see all the gold in the holy place. There's tons of it in there.
Yeah, I had a look there before they sanctified it. But of course, it's priests only now.
Solomon wanted to build a temple worthy of a great God. And that's what he's done.
Come on, aren't you finished with that yet?
Yeah, wait a minute. I just want to shave off a fraction off the edge here. It'll be the last chance we get.
You're a perfectionist. But everything must be just right for this great day.
There were times when I wondered if this great day would ever arrive. To think that we've been working on this for 20 years.
20 years.
And in a few minutes' time, King Solomon himself will arrive to dedicate this holy place.
Come on, you better clear up your tools or we're going to have to stay here for the opening ceremony. It's going to be quite an occasion. Come on, hurry up.
No, you can't rush these things.
But look, all the priests and people are arriving. We'd be disturbing things if we climbed down now.
Yeah, come on. We better climb down now. We'll be stuck up here.
There's Solomon. Oh. And he'd recognise us if we climbed down now.
All right.
We'd better stay up here and watch. It's a good view from up here. And I can see the procession. I can see the ark.
Yes, all right. But for goodness sake, keep quiet.
I have succeeded my father as king of Israel, and I have built this temple for the worship of the Lord God of Israel. I have made a place in the temple for the covenant box, containing the stone tablets of the covenant, which the Lord God made with our ancestors when he brought them out of Egypt. Now, O God, look on us and listen to the prayers offered in this place, and with the covenant box, the symbol of your power, enter this place and stay here forever. Let the ceremony continue. We'll be right back.
happened?
You are.
What's happened?
God has filled the temple with his spirit.
But why?
When you glimpse God's glory, you can do nothing but praise him.
But they can't continue with the ceremony.
I told you, when you do, when you glimpse God's glory, you can do nothing but praise him. Look at them.
But how can God really live on earth? Not even all heaven is large enough to hold him. So how can this temple that we've built be large enough?
There is no God in heaven or on the earth like him.
Lord, you are my God, and I am your servant. Forgive me my sins. Forgive us all our sins, for all have sinned. Watch over this temple and hear the prayers of your people Israel. And when a prayer or plea is made, hear from your home in heaven. Praise to the Lord, for he is good and his love is eternal. Praise the Lord, the God of Israel.
Single-handed, Elijah took on King Ahab, Queen Jezebel, and the false prophets of Baal. He was out to show that the God of Israel was real and to challenge the people to decide which God they were going to serve.
Come on, folks. If you want decent crops, then you must worship Baal.
You just can't expect to use this land and not worship its local god.
I tell you, if you don't worship Baal, you'll have lousy crops and you'll live to regret it.
So come on then, who's for Baal?
People of Israel, choose this day whom you will serve. You cannot worship Baal and the Lord God Almighty. If Baal is God, then worship him. But if the Lord is God, worship him. Choose between Baal made of sticks and stones and the maker of heaven and earth.
What's he getting so steamed up about?
I don't know. After all, we don't mind you worshipping his God, as long as you spare a thought for Baal as well.
So there you go, folks. Compromise is the best policy. Follow both gods and make sure you're right. Don't pay any attention to him. He's mad.
No! How much longer will you waver between two opinions? If Baal is God, worship him. But if the Lord is God, worship him alone.
Look, Elijah, there are 450 of us and only one of you. Why don't you give it up as a bad job?
Yeah, Elijah. It's about time you realised the crowd are on our side.
Yeah.
I challenge you this day to test and see who is the Lord God Almighty. Prepare your altar with wood and the sacrifice, and I shall do the same. Then call upon the name of Baal, and I shall cry out to the name of my Lord. And we shall see who answers. The one who answers with fire, he is God.
Has Baal done fire before?
Yeah, must have.
Very well. We accept your challenge.
Make way for the prophets of Baal. Okay, lads, let's show them.
Yeah.
What's the matter? Is Baal asleep? Or shout louder! Wake him up! Or maybe he's not satisfied with your offering. Or maybe he's nipped out to relieve himself. Or maybe he's not a god at all. Now it's my turn. You can pour water on my altar if you like. For I know the Lord my God will answer my plea.
Oh Lord, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Israel, let it be known this day, I am your servant. Oh Lord, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Israel, let it be known.
God of Abraham and Isaac, prove now that you are the God of Israel and that I am your servant. Answer me, Lord, answer me, and show that you are bringing these people back to yourself. A choice?
In the time of Ezekiel the prophet, the people of Israel were exiles in Babylonia. For them, life had no meaning and no hope. Ezekiel helped them to see beyond their own situation.
For the night. We can shelter against the rock and build a fire. Gather what sticks you can. Oh, what's the matter now? What's going on? Oh, my dear, it's nothing to be frightened of. It's just an old bone. He can't hurt you. You go back to the others. Poor Naomi. She scares so easily. She jumps at her own shadow. She's seen so much violence. She saw her own parents killed. And that's a heavy load for a young mind. But it's a heavy load we all must bear. All right, there's bread in the cart, but we must go easy or there'll be none left tomorrow. How's the fire coming on? Surely there must be something we can burn.
Burn your idols.
Do you have a body or do you just a voice?
Do not be afraid. I am quite alone. I am a prophet of the Lord Jehovah, the one true God, and that is why I say again, you must burn your idols.
We're Israelites, God's chosen people. We've no idols. God's chosen people. Jerusalem has fallen. The Babylonians are running riot through the city, killing and burning everything to the ground. We have had to leave everything and run for our lives. Jerusalem is ransacked. The holy city is defiled. We have nowhere to turn. Everything is finished. There is no hope. My possessions are burned. My house is gone. My children are carried as slaves into a foreign land. I weep for my children. What hope is there in God for Israel?
God made you a promise. He made you the chosen people. He gave you the promised land. But you stupid people, you defiled that land with your idols and turned your back on God with your wickedness.
God forgive us. Lord, have mercy. We have lost everything.
Mortal man, can these bones, the people of Israel, ever come back to life? Only the sovereign God can answer that. See the vision that the Lord God has given me for you. Dry bones. Listen to the word of the Lord. The Lord says that he will put breath into you and bring you back to life. He will give you muscles and sinews to cover them with. He will put breath into you and he will bring you back to life. And then you will know that he is the Lord. people of Israel are like these dry bones. You say that you have no hope, you're dried up, there's no hope, there's no future. But the Lord says, I will put breath into you and I will bring you back to life. And you shall live in the land of your own. And then you will know that I am the Lord.
Then come, true God, and breathe in us that we may live. Let's praise the Lord.
Mary was not rich, famous, or important, yet God chose her to be the mother of Jesus.
sometimes wonder what the world's coming to.
What's wrong, Salome? Have you had a busy day?
Those wretched Roman soldiers. Two of them made me carry their bags to the edge of the town in all this heat.
That's a bit mean. They could have chosen someone a bit younger than you.
I mean, why can't they carry their own bags? I'll be glad when we see the back of them.
Still, it's good news about the betrothal, isn't it?
What betrothal?
Between Mary and Joseph, of course.
Are you sure? I haven't heard about it.
Of course, everybody's talking about it.
Well, that is good news. They make a lovely couple.
Yes. I wonder what the dowry was.
I've no idea. I don't know how anyone can afford to get married these days with these wretched Roman taxes the way they are.
I know, we're finding it hard to make ends meet.
You know, I sometimes wonder what the world's coming to.
Stop being so pessimistic. Cheer up. The Messiah will come soon.
That's all very well. But when? We seem to have been waiting for so long.
The rabbi thinks it might be soon.
I only hope he's right.
Look, there's Mary.
Congratulations, Mary.
And may the Lord greatly bless you, my dear.
My spirit shall rejoice.
Until his baptism, people had probably regarded Jesus as just the son of Joseph and Mary. But now God made it clear that he had a plan for his son.
Come on, we're nearly there.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Oh, come on, hurry up, you'll miss it.
I don't know what all this fuss is about anyway.
Look, everyone from the Thames down by the riverbank.
What on earth's happening? Is the Emperor coming?
No, it's John, the prophet. You know.
You mean to say you dragged me all the way up here just to listen to him? He's boring.
Yes, but he's not just talking. He's drowning people.
Don't be stupid. He's probably baptizing them.
But what's he doing that for?
It's a sign, of course.
Yeah, but why duck them in the water?
To show they want to start again by baptizing them. They've been washed clean.
Anyway, hurry up. It's worth seeing. There, look, they're over there.
Thank you.
of the Lord is upon me to open the prisoner's door, to give sight to the blind, to tell the world the time has come. The Lord will save his people. When the Lord will save his people. Open the prisoner's door, to give sight to the blind, and tell the world the time has come. When the Lord will save his people, when the Lord will save his people. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, good news to the poor. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, to open the prisoner's door, to give sight to the blind, to tell the world the time has come. When the Lord will save his people. 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 The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Jesus made many promises to his followers. One of the most important for us today is his promise of the Holy Spirit.
We could search a million years, we'd never find a light so clear. There is no greater love. Love that has opened every door. Love that's been everywhere before. There is no greater love. This love so my spirit might be free. This love has sacrificed everything for me. Love that can open every door. Love that's been everywhere before. There is no greater.
The disciples were feeling depressed and probably quite afraid now that Jesus had gone. What had he meant when he told them he would not leave them alone? Meeting together at least gave them company.
Aren't drunk. It's only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, they haven't been drinking. What you see before you is the fulfillment of Joel's prophecy. He promised that God would come down and pour out his spirit among us, that our sons and daughters would prophesy, that our young men would see visions, that our old men would dream dreams. Well, the day has come. His prophecy has come true. And why has this happened? I'll tell you why, if only you'll hear me out. You killed Jesus. You nailed him to a cross. But that wasn't the end of him. God raised him from the dead, and now he sits at the right hand of God. What you see and hear before you today is God pouring out his spirit among us. And what should you do, I hear you ask? What indeed? Turn away from your sins. Be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ and receive forgiveness for your sins. And you will receive God's gift, the Holy Spirit.
When John was a prisoner on the island of Patmos, he had a vision. The vision was both encouragement to Christians who were suffering for their faith and condemnation of those whose faith was failing.
I have a message for you. I have a message for you. Yes, it's me. It's John. I've been away such a long time. A prisoner on the island of Patmos. The authorities locked me there because my message so offended them. But now, my brothers and sisters in the churches, I have a message for you. It happened on the Lord's Day. I was praising God. And then, suddenly, the power of God's Spirit took control of me. I saw a being that looked like a man. He wore a robe that reached to his feet. His hair was white as wool. His eyes blazed like fire. His face shone like the midday sun. I fell down at his feet like a dead man. And he came over and placed his hands on my head. And he said to me, I was dead, but now I am alive forever. And he told me to write down this message for you. This message for the churches in Ephesus and Smyrna, Thyatira and Sardis and Pergamum and Philadelphia and Laodicea. I have a message for you. I have a message for you. You have lost your first love. You need to repent.
You think that you are strong, but really you are weak.
This love, this sacrifice. And I looked again, and I saw the new Jerusalem, the holy city, descending out of heaven from God. And I heard the angels say, "Look, there is the spring of the water of life. All who are thirsty may drink freely from it." The one who is sitting on the throne said, "I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Whoever is thirsty may come and drink freely from the spring of the water of life." And the Spirit said, "Come, come, whoever is thirsty, come and drink from the spring of God's love."
Shine in our eyes. the end of this lovely night together, let's give it to God. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this time we've shared, and we thank you for your power, which has, ever since the dawn of creation, surrounded this world of ours and blessed us through all the centuries in a mighty way. And now in this day, in this generation, Lord, give us the vision to love you and serve you and yield ourselves to you. And by the power of your Spirit, send us out to change this nation for your glory. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Please stand. The house lights will come on the workbooks and also on the programs. You'll find the words to give us a vision. Let's sing together.